thought I would start and end with a picture of the sea, just because we all came from it. I'm working on a project at the moment called Homestay with Hack the City, and practically what it is trying to house most or all of the international artists coming to take part in the festival in local people's houses instead of hotels. And the idea of it is accepting that that happens and it allows for festivals like this to happen all the time, but making it a visible, celebrated part of the festival that everybody can participate in instead of something that goes on behind the scenes. That led me to thinking about other moments in society or in culture that I had seen where it was about making the ordinary visible. This is the High Line. It's a park in New York City that I'm sure some of you have been to. It's a former train tracks just above the meatpacking district that's been turned into this reclaimed park. And one of the most interesting parts for me was that there are these bleachers where you sit and you just look at the road from a sort of screen effect. So I thought it was an amazing way of taking the ordinary and the invisible in a city and turning it into a celebrated visible thing. This is a truck called Cargo Sophia that I spent 3 weeks working on in Warsaw in 2006 as part of the Mobile Academy. It's basically a big cargo truck that's been gutted and the entire outside has been turned into a mirror that you can see out of, but people just see a reflection when they look back at it. One of my favourite things was people kind of coming up to it and fixing their makeup while you were standing inside it. So we drove around and intervened in the city and created different spectacles of the ordinary. So we would go up alongside the tram and then send someone into the tram and watch them and do sort of performances with that. And so I'm very interested in this idea of making ordinary things more visible, but then also looking at what is invisible in society. So I've decided to poignantly illustrate that with three blank slides coming up now. While I was proposing Homestay, I was in New York City again, and I met with a former student of mine called Camilo Godoy, who's a Colombian-born artist. And by an incident of just his mother marrying an American man, he became a legal citizen of the United States. But he's very interested in this idea of who he would be if he was not a legal citizen there and who he is now as a legal citizen. So he brought me out where he goes regularly every week to an immigration detention center for non-criminals, but people that are held indefinitely for having no legal papers. And while we were there, coming up to the security entrance, I realized that I'd forgotten my passport and was encountered with the entire ICE, very, very scary men who told me that I had signed a document on the way into the United States saying that I would carry my passport with me at all times and that I was liable to be held there myself. They let me in because I was Irish. Basically, they passed my provisional driving license around to everybody. And at the end, the kind of big shot guy said, "Where are you from?" I said, "Dublin." He said, "Killarney. Go in." But while I was in there, we visited. I felt, to be honest, like I wasn't going to be able to relate to the people that we met in this place. But when we were in there, I realized that the people there were just people that had arbitrarily been put in this different situation. So I decided that Homestay had to have this kind of more broad context. So I set up a reading group called On Hospitality to go alongside the project. The pictures just before were of a film called Sea View, which is about the detention center holding space in Mosny, and there's an Irish film called Sea View about that we're going to screen as part of the reading group. So we're having screenings, discussions about ideas of hospitality, immigration, the other. One of the other things we're looking at is ritual, and I decided to illustrate the Irish ritual of tea drinking by this very funny poster outside Galway City. So we're holding feasts for the Homestay hosts who decide to put up artists and for the artists themselves and people who get involved in the project in another way. This is a feast we just held in the Superfast building on Tuesday evening this week for hosts and artists. We wanted to find a very good way to community feed everybody, so we fed them from gutters going down the centre of the table. So we'll be holding more of these events, and it would be great to have more hosts come and get involved and make visible this idea of people sharing resources, opening up their homes. And for me, my personal belief is that people do want to share and they do want to encounter the other and they want to bring people into their lives. So Homestay is basically about celebrating that. You also get a lovely complimentary screen-printed bag when you participate. I should have put other ones for longer. So I ended on the sea, and this is the sea now, as it is in Sea Point, and this is my ritual. I go swimming it all the time, and I've also realised in a way that this project is mostly me trying to get as many people as possible to swim in the Irish Sea. So our first Homestay artist, Florian Riviere, was a really good sport. He stayed in there for ages. So I'm going to finish on a quote by Rachel Carson from the book The Sea Around Us, if I may go beyond time. "When they went ashore, the animals that took up a land life carried with them a part of the sea in their bodies, a heritage which they passed on to their children, and which even today links each land animal with its origin in the ancient sea. Fish, amphibian and reptile, warm-blooded bird and mammal, each of us carries in our veins a salty stream in which the elements sodium, potassium and calcium are combined in almost the same proportions as in seawater. So there's even a bit of science there. Thank you.